Hey, good news. I'm here with Julie Fryer, and we're going to be talking today about how your network contributes to your security and how to make it more secure without spending a year doing it. Welcome to the Azure Enablement Show, where we'll be discussing the challenges you and our other tech-savvy customers have encountered. Together, we'll be talking with experts to find out how they think about these problems, recommended tools and best practices, and tips they've learned from years of experience that you can use. So today, we're really lucky because we're going to be talking to Julie Fryer, Security Cloud Solutions Architect and Identity. And I think for this conversation, I'm going to switch to being a customer. So let me switch to customer mode. Okay, in customer mode. Hey, Julie, thanks for taking the time to talk to me today. So I've got another audit problem I want to ask you about that I just don't understand. We just had an audit done, and what it came back was this thing that said, we have a flat network, and that's a problem. And I don't know what that means and why it's a problem. Can you tell me what they're trying to tell me here?
That's a good question, David. I have a slide for that. Let me explain a flat versus a segmented network. A flat network is where you have a firewall, which is a layer 7 firewall, which inspects traffic going onto your network. They usually have a virtual local area network, and then inside of that, a subnet. And the subnet has its own IP address range. But what they usually do when you have a flat network is put all the applications in one subnet. And the problem with that is that if a bad actor gets into one of those applications, they can pivot to the entire subnet and get into all of the applications, and you're going to have a really big compromise on your hands. In addition to this, a lot of times when an auditor finds a flat network, they also find that the network is deployed in default settings. And what that means is that a lot of bad actors already know what the default settings are on these networks, and they will spoof the switch and impersonate the administrator and get into the network as well. So it's not a really good thing when you have a flat network. So as opposed to a flat network, Azure Cloud, we have what's called a segmented network, or you can call it a segmented network. We still have the Azure layer 7 firewall that will inspect traffic, but we can do some micro segmentation and get the applications a little more secure than a flat network.
Okay, cool. So I understand the difference now, and I understand why it's a real problem to have a flat network. But the next recommendation has me really nervous because it says something about rearchitecting our network. And that sounds like a big project. Am I right about that?
Yeah, that's correct. Because on a flat network or a local area network on premise, you would have to create multiple subnets, and you would have to decide which applications go into which subnet so that you can isolate the broadcasting, because each subnet's going to broadcast to the entire subnet, and any application in that subnet is going to be able to get to each other. And the messages travel pretty freely that way once they're within that subnet. You can add a lot of security rules, but what happens when you add all the security rules in the subnet, then if you need to make a change, you've got to go through the hierarchy. And if you change one rule in the middle and it doesn't do well for the rules on the top or the bottom, then you're going to have a little bit of a mess on your hands. And sometimes that actually causes a security issue when the rules are changed within that subnet. So it can take a long time to get that right.
Yeah, and I don't have the sense based on this audit that we have a lot of time. So is there anything I can do besides a full-on whole year effort to re-architect my network in the meantime, or just to be where I want to be?
Yeah. So for in the Azure Cloud, we make it possible so that you can just do a complete lift and shift and set up your applications a little similar, but a little bit different. In the Azure Cloud, we still have the same thing that you have on premise with your layer 7 Azure firewall, or you can use another firewall if you don't want to use the Azure firewall. It's going to inspect your traffic. We also have what is called a VNet instead of a VLAN. And then we have network security groups that you can do some more micro segmentation with, which is a layer 4, meaning that it's going to handle the source and destination traffic and keep out what you don't want to see. And then we have subnets just like on-premise. But the difference is here, you wouldn't have to start you know, making a whole bunch of different subnets and creating a whole bunch of different rules within that subnet, we have what's called our application security groups, which is also another layer four. So you can have yet another set of IP addresses within the same subnet, separate from other applications. So an application security group can be dedicated to one application. Say you have a legal application, an HR application, and an intellectual property application. And all of a sudden you find out, okay, I've got to, you know, lift and shift, get this to the cloud, and I want to make sure that they don't talk to each other. You can specify the IP range for each application using application security groups. If you need to all of a sudden change the security rule, you can change it in one application security group and it will not affect the other application security group because they're all dedicated to those applications. Or you can group, a bunch of applications into one application security group. But also, if you need to allow a port to and from VMs, you can make the change in a single rule with these application security groups. So it makes, you know, networking and segmenting and creating a zero trust network a little bit easier when you use the Azure cloud.
So I have to say, you had me at the, yes, this is a lot easier. I don't need to spend an entire year doing this and I can do it per application. Like that was totally convincing. So how would I get started if I wanted to get into the application security group game?
So if you have an Azure subscription, you would set up a VNet and then a network security group, a subnet, and then assign your application security groups. And you're going to dedicate resource groups to every single one of these objects. And usually it takes a couple of clicks to set everything up.
Cool. That sounds awesome. And it sounds like I've got some homework to do. Well, thank you very much. I think I should probably head back to being a host now. Okay, back to host mode. And as part of host mode, I just want to thank you, Julie, for helping this customer, helping me as a customer and this sort of stuff. I thought that went great. And I hope this is useful to you. So with that, what I'd like to do is just thank everybody who's watching this. Thank you for watching this episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Please don't forget to like, connect, share, and subscribe, and join us again to watch more in the Azure Enablement Show.